Thank you. whoever receives me receives him who sent me. For he who is least among you all will be great. Now John answered and said, Master, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we forbade him because he does not follow with us. But Jesus said to him, Do not forbid him, for he who is not against us is on our side. There ends the meeting.
Alleluia, alleluia, sap sare caminaetanos, alabaget sectoros plus, et ainsus otium.
Alleluia, hoci,
I'm not.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh,
Oh,
Oh.
will suffer until we will see in heaven. I absolve you of all participation in sin, in thought, in word, and in deed, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and we instate you in the sacraments of the Holy Church, that whatsoever you may do, may be come to you for good, and for the glory of the life to come. Amen.
Yeah,
Yeah.
և մարգարեից դու ես Քրիստոս Աստված մեր, որ մտցեր զանինան հալալան ու նյութիս քո, ինձ ես մեր օգոտ քո սեքով։
Scheduled to that various feasts of the day. And as we enter the fixed season of Advent, the anticipation of coming of Christ, and the anticipation of the great news about the invitation to be members of the kingdom of God, the church has chosen this reading from the Gospel of Luke, which was chanted to us by a beloved deacon people from Mexico, New York. And the reading is about a story our Lord narrates, which is copied in the Gospel of Luke. The evangelist tells us our Lord was teaching about the kingdom of God, about life within the reign and the rule of God, about life where there's no lying and deception and wars and egos and all these things. But unfortunately, the disciples did not understand exactly what he was talking about. While he was talking about his crucifixion and his voluntary sacrifice to pay the ransom of our sins and liberate us from the shackles of eternal death and sin, the apostles were arguing, when we go to the kingdom of God, who will be senior amongst us? Who will sit closest to God? And they were trying to impose worldly limitations on the unlimited joy of the kingdom and the presence of God. And thus, they were arguing who is greatest in Jesus. And Jesus, to reorient their focus and bring it back to the core of the gospel message, chose a child. And looking at the child, he told them, unless you accept this child, unless you receive this child, you will not receive me. Or in other words, unless you receive this child, you will not receive me. And he receives me, receives God. In other words, if you want to be in the kingdom of God, you must receive me and receive my teaching. And in order to receive my teaching, you have to be able to receive this child. It's a bit enigmatic, difficult to say, what does he mean by receive this child? To understand this saying, we need to go back to the Old Testament and investigate the role, the function of a child in the society of those days. Childs were powerless, helpless, no status in the society. In the court, they couldn't witness, they were not valued as a witness. They had no say. They were the most powerless element in the society. In other words, our Lord is saying, unless you are ready to understand that in the kingdom of God, there is no greater and greater and greatest. We are all equal to the kingdom of God. As long as we receive the gospel and abide by the gospel, the price that I will pay through my crucifixion will be the ransom of your liberation from the shackles of sin and death. But if you're not like this child, willing to accept this beautiful gift from God, you will not be worthy of the kingdom of God. Children in those days, until today most of the time, life has changed a bit, were very simple. They trusted 100% those who took care of them, their parents. They followed their instructions 100% without questioning why. They trusted their lives into the hands of those who created them and nurtured them, the parents.
Jesus said, unless you are willing like this child to surrender your life into the hands of the Lord and realize that ultimately He is in charge of your life, you will not be able to enter the kingdom of God. That doesn't mean, by the way, be passive, don't do anything, be lazy, don't work, and God will take care of it. Obviously not. But He's saying, be like a child, totally committed to God, trusting God. No matter how much difficulty in your life is, ultimately, God will rescue you. There must be a reason why God is exposing you to this difficulty and to this challenge. While they're discussing this issue, the apostles go further in not understanding them and say, Lord, there's not a group of people preaching the same thing that we are preaching, that you taught us, but they are not one of us. Another thing that our society gradually teaches us, that children are desensitized, don't know about that. The isms, belonging to a group, belonging to a sector within the society, religion, sex, gender, ethnicity, all these things. A child at the age of 2 or 3 and 4 or 5 does not know the differences. But once he grows up in this fallen world, he starts picking the indications of what does it mean to be rich, to be poor, to be affluent, to be not affluent, to be the lowest layer of the society, and to be when somebody comes and visits our school, our house, we don't say, oh, he prays 5 times. We say he drives him out. He drives the proceedings. He has a memory. We teach our children to value the person by his isms, worldly wealth, group he belongs to, the ethnic group he comes from, sometimes he buys education. These are all good things, but there should not be grounds for segregating people in the kingdom of God. There's no us and them. As long as we believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ, we are sons and daughters of the gospel of Jesus Christ. That brings me to the last and final note. I don't want to drag most of your time. We have celebration. In that sense, the Armenian church, my beloved, is part of the eternal church of Jesus Christ. There's no such thing. But in the Armenian church, we do this. There's one church, one holy universal church, which was founded by Jesus. And that church thrives and is nurtured by the words of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Nothing else. There's nothing. Well, our church is different. I've heard that so many times from our faithful Armenians. There's no difference. There's no them preaching and us preaching. As long as the gospel of Jesus Christ, we are members of that universal church. Now we have our own ethnic traditions that have been molded around this beautiful gospel and living it for 2,000 years. Our own hymns, our own vestments, our own prayers, which beautifully baptizes the Armenian culture to show the gospel of Jesus Christ. But that doesn't make us a special church, different than the other churches when it comes to application of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We are all different branches preaching the same gospel. And thus, it brings us to then what does the function of the church remain in this whole overall picture of today's reading? Well, the church or the parish is charged with responsibility to make sure that the gospel is preached. So our children and grandchildren learn the gospel of Jesus Christ. I understand that there are no isms in the kingdom of God, that there are no us and them in the kingdom of God, that there's no greater and lower and richer and poorer in the gospel of God, that there are no ones who be closer to the throne of God and those who are away from the kingdom of God. We are all equal as long as we accept the gospel of Jesus Christ and we accept Him, the Lord, as a ransom which paid the price of our sin. I remember when I was in New York, about 30 years ago, when they attacked the Twin Towers, there was a certain firefighter who did not know anybody in these towers. But he went to rescue. He was not doing zero duty. He just wanted to help. And after rescuing 200-300 people, he walked in and he was rescuing a few people with some policemen as they were escaping that room or whatever, the room collapsed on him.
And this man, that he was dying, was his final breaths. And he turned to the policeman and said, "This is my young murderer. Please tell my wife I love her, and please pray for me." And the man died. How can this man, the policeman, not remember his firefighter who gave his life to rescue him? He didn't even know. Christ gave his life to rescue us, people born 2,000 years after his crucifixion. How can we not know and not remember and not pray for him today? This is the duty of the church. This is the duty of the parish, and I hope as your parish enters this new anniversary. Long time ago, I heard about Milwaukee, and I was a shepherd. Our guest is Daniel from this region. I've been here several times, 30 years ago or so, and I'm glad to see that you're still surviving continuing. I pray to the Lord that the Lord may strengthen you to continue the ministry of the gospel of Jesus Christ, preaching this gospel, strengthening our children in the moral values of our faith, so that together with the rest of the Christian world, may be one day worthy to cross this threshold and return to the eternal existence with Christ, to whom be His glory, dominion, and honor until the end of times.
Today, on the 80th anniversary of St. John the Baptist Armenian Church, we remember and commemorate all those departed souls who served this community with faith and dedication, including those who were instrumental in the parish's inception, clergymen, visiting clergy, and altar servers, parish council members, women's guild, various committee members, godfathers, and donors. So we will be doing requiem service for the souls of Archbishop Gareki Hovhannesian, who consecrated the First Church. Dear Reverend Bishop Zvon Derdenyan, Reverend Father Forem Mamigonyan, Reverend Father Gareki Hovhannesian, Asadur Kalashyan, Mamre Ohanya, Hovhannesian Muranyan, Krikor Panosyan, Yervan Derderyan, Sahak Muranyan, Krikor Abrahamyan, Avetis Haidyan, Hovhannes Muranyan, Nagardich Muranyan, Mamre Ohanya, Agok Kionishyan, Khachadur Abdalyan, Ayganush Kelevyan, Ayganush Chobenyan, Very Reverend Father Sukyas Kalfayan, Reverend Father Hortanes Papazian, Reverend Father Jurek Galvayan, Very Reverend Father Shnor Kasparian, Reverend Father Pari Medjian, Reverend Father Horen Mamigonyan, Very Reverend Father Barujan Tabarajian, Reverend Father Krikor Hayrabedian, Reverend Father Dajal Tavitian, Reverend Father Hai Konikian, His Eminence Ketchar Korko Marukian, Harold Bailerian, Dr. Senekeri Marmara, Hayrabed Kalakian, Charles Dadayan, whose 40th day of his passing is today, Orga Busey, Harry Korosian, Edward Hampalian, Arthur Kation, Garabed Avjian, Diramaev Mari Kelekian, Charles Dadayan, Hachik Chobenyan, Archdeacon Samuel Avakian, Harry Korosian, Alice Busey, Alice Kation, Archie Dedian, Miriam Kalakian, Ann Avakian, Rose Hayden, Edward Artinian, Helen Keshian, Betty Ellen, Rosemary Armada, Makruhi Asadurian, Diane Blinka, Ann Avakian, Alice Pusey, Mary Chobanian, Mary Ekesian, Dikranui Hamparian, Rose Hayden, Shaki Kalajan, Pranush Kamakian, Areknas Keshian, Ahavni Manyan, Akape Nishanyan, Ahavni Muratyan, Rose Pankukjan, and Terry Hazan. May God the Holy Name and the souls in peace.
Thank you.
he falls into the earth and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, there is much fruit. He loves his world and this fallen world, and in his life in this fallen world, he loves it. And he who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. If anyone serves me, he must follow me. And where I am, this is my heavenly be also. If anyone serves me,
Reverend Father Karekim Bogakimian,
members of the original parish council, Pasadun, Karashan, Mamrev, Oanyan, Oladin, Muladyan, Vigor, Parashan, Yevan, Deberyan, Sahar, Muladyan, Vigor, Abrahamyan, Avidis, Aida. Remember also, O Lord, the souls of your servants, Sahar, Muladyan, Olades, Muladyan, Deberyich, Muladyan, Mamrevanyan, Oladin, Muladyan, Avidis, Aida, Ado, Kernishyan, Kajadur, Abkadyan, Ayanush, Kedetyan, Ayanush, Jovanyan. And the clergy, Father Tsukyas, Kafayan, Father Vertanes, Papasyan, Father Greb, Kafayan, Reverend Father Shnor, Kasparyan, Reverend Father Pani Menchyan, and Mystic Clergy, Father Foret Namikonyan, Father Banjan Kabarajyan, Father Grigor Ayarindyan, Father Dajat Dabindyan, and Father Hari Dobindyan. Remember also the Lord of His Eminence, Patriarch Turkom Amindyan, then Primate of the Diocese. Remember the soul of the architect, Harold Bavaria, and the deceased godfathers of the parish, Dr. Seni Kerim, Admagan, Ayabed, Karajan, Charles Dandyan, whose 14th day of passing be commemorated. Orville, UC, Abby Torosyan, Edward Omarian, Arthur, Kishan, Arabet, Abjian, and the original members of the building committee, Yamai Mary Kerigan, Harold Bedelian, Charles Bedelian, Hachik Chobanyan, Archdeacon Samuel Dabakyan, Abby Torosyan, Orville Busey, Alice Busey, Alice Kenshian, Arabet Abjian, and Archie Badian. Remember also, Lord, members of the Consecration Committee, Marian Kenigan, Alice Busey, and Abakyan. The 1986 Parish Council, Rose Island, Edward Martinian, and the souls of the Members of Women's Guild, Ellen, Kate Shan, Betty Ellen, Rosemary Armagan, Makruhi Asaduyan, Diane Rinka, Anne Abakya, Alice Busey, Mary Chobanyan, Mary Ephesian, Ikrahuhi Ampagyan, Rose Hyden, Alice Kate Shan, Marian Kalegan, Shaker Kalejan, Ramush Kamakyan, Arignaz Hachyan, Iranai Mary Kalekyan, Ababli Manyan, Akabi Nishanyan, Ababli Muradyan, Rose Pambuchyan, and Mary Pazankin. Remember them, O Lord, of the great day of the coming of your kingdom. Make them worthy of remission and expiation of sins. Illuminate and lighten among the saints at your right hand, for you are the Lord and Creator of all, judge of the living and of the dead. And Jesus, with whom you glory and honor, now and always, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
Prayers, which we use until today. And because of this, our church
honors its members today with the highest medal recognized by His Holiness, the Kodos of Armenian, known as the Neshesh Morali Medal. And I'm glad that Father Kurev recognized amongst you one of your parishioners, well, I'm sure many of you are, with your best medal. I want to invite him to recognize his name and then invite him to receive the medal and then go back from His Holiness.
I would like to invite Father Churchan to receive His Holiness I, the second medal of St. Mercedes Morales.
And may the Lord Jesus Christ remain with us all. Amen.